Tuesday, May 6th in the year of our Lord, 2014. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's two for Tuesday, so that's right. Two babes, two hunks, two songs, two beers, two trivia questions, and a lot of fun. So yeah, as the song says, it's a great day to whip someone's ass. You know why? Because Mama Nature's whooping my ass. 100 degrees down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. I know our lovely lady admin Gidget loves that kind of heat. Love Doctor don't like that kind of heat. No. Well, how about our unofficial sponsor of today's show? Our original baby. My good friend Crystal Lloyd Dolzani. Crystal Addiction out of Casper, Wyoming. She is an aspiring actress. She's a pinup model. She's a burlesque dancer. She runs a travel agency on her own personal business. She also is a published poet, and she knows it twice. That's right. So take that page, Crystal Addiction. Follow it. Awesome stuff. She does it all. Legendary lady indeed, and a dear friend of mine I know originally from jolly old England, where she was a badass age ranger. Didn't start because danger is no stranger to an age ranger. So there you go. How about a Route 66 beer consumption apparatus? Today's beer of the day, boys, girls, and it's Sam Adams escape route. Why? Because I need an escape route from this heat. Good God, send me up to Baker Lake, Nunavut, Canada, where it's like 0 degrees right now. 5%, that's normal strength beer, pride of Boston, Massachusetts, best city in the world. That's right. Home of my beloved Boston Red Sox. Probably opening up rash pump technique, here we go. 45 degree angle right into the beer consumption apparatus, right over the keyboard, because I'm just that damn good. Have a spill drop yet, never have, never will. With a day this hot, kind of want a thinner beer, you know what I mean? And I think escape route's a good option for that. Cheers to all of you pros to say Germany, goodbye is the same Japan. Ooh. Good beer, nice average beer. I mean, average beer for Sam Adams is a B. Good. Nothing special, just a good beer right here. Cold style.
I had to sing it with my eyes closed to hide my shame.
Fruit notes, subtle fruit notes of an ale with the smooth crispness of a lager for a bright, refreshing brew to help escape those lingering cold days. Well, shit. How about if we escape those hot, sweltery days? That's what's going on up here. All right, well, we got a bunch of celebrity birthdays. Well, hell, my friends are all celebrities. A happy birthday goes to my good friend Alex Taylor, a sweetheart of a lady that I know from Martha's Vineyard Island, and I've known her for, like, God, 25 years now, pretty much. Wow. Real sweetheart of a lady, an awesome mom, an awesome wife, an awesome friend, and just totally wicked awesome. Final standing graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School, class of 1993, the pride of Aquinnah, formerly known as Gayhead. Prior to that, formerly known as Aquinnah. Hey, well, there you go. Alex, my friend, like I'd ever forget your birthday, right? Come on. Well, hope you're doing well. Love to hear from you. Been a little bit since I've heard from you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. And hey, celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, my very own aunt. She is absolutely phenomenal. My Aunt Betty Lou Hindle. Aunt Betty Lou, how are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Always great hearing from you. And looking at your post earlier today, looks like you're doing great. No surprise there. And I definitely miss you. I love you. We all love you. And hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Yeah, my mother's older sister. A wonderful lady indeed. Next on the list, how about my good friend Rebecca Gesquire, a comical nav wizard, a great leader of men, women, and it. She's living in California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon, and I know her from jolly old England. Becca, how you doing? Hope you're doing well, and I hope your wonderful lesser half, Matt, spoils the hell out of you. I'm sure he will. He's a hell of a guy. And definitely miss working with the two of you big time. Hey, I miss In-N-Out Burger, too, and I know you get to enjoy that stuff every so often. Rebecca, hope you have a wicked awesome day. Like I said, definitely miss you. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my very own cousin, Cathy Karras. That's right, the better half of my oldest cousin, Darren. Cathy, how you doing? Hope you're doing well. She's always planning and coordinating the family events now. She's really done an awesome job with that. Wicked awesome. And Cathy, how about that? You and Aunt Betty Lou, same birthday. Did you know that? Well, if you didn't, you do now. Because you know me, I don't forget birthdays. Well, hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, my man Charlie Goucher. Now here's a walking brain of a man, das dude. He's a pointy-headed legend of a man that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. That's right, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, same damn state. Yep, well Charlie, what is up my man? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And I know you're going to take your birthday. And brother, you need to party hard and enjoy, celebrate like it's 1969, minus the acid. Hey, cheer the beers to you, huh? Hope you enjoy the show. Next on the list. I knew her as Hillary Kerr. Hillary Miller, a wonderful sweetheart of a lady that I know from good old Martha's Vineyard. I don't Vineyard here in Massachusetts, best town in the world. Now see, I went to school with her older sister, Gina. And Hillary, I've known you a long time. You and Gina always, you know, walking together and everything. Just two wonderful, wonderful ladies. And Hillary, I can't remember, but I want to say you are a fine, outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1995. Am I correct on that? Or was it 94? I think it was 95, though. Excuse me. Ooh, wow. Well, Hillary, hey, always great hearing from you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right, the final birthday of the day goes to a wonderful lady I have yet to meet in person. But I know her through my good friend Paul Goolsby, a great legend of a man that I worked with in jolly old England. That's right, Audrey Goolsby. Now, didn't we play Farmville together at one time on the old Facebook? I think we did. But you're just such an awesome lady and an awesome friend, and I really hope we meet in person someday. You're always welcome to come down here to Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana, if you so choose. Hey, the world is small. Remember, you can get anywhere in the world in 24 hours or less, okay? Keep that in mind. It can happen. But yeah, Audrey, told you it was going to be, you said it yourself, it's going to be a wicked day. Well, how about a wicked awesome day? Michelle Chenille, French for wicked awesome, huh? You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada, indeed. You got to give some love to our neighbors up north. With exception of the Montreal Canadiens hockey team that gets to play my Bruins tonight. Hey, Montreal Canadiens goaltender Carey Price had the nerve to say that the Bruins got lucky in game two. Really? You dumb schlepper. What are you thinking? Nothing like a little bit of poster board material. I hope we light them up like a Christmas tree tonight. Well, Audrey, my friend, I hope you do have a wicked awesome day, and I know you will. Hey, celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right, we had a couple trivia questions. Oh, and these were doozies. Thank you to my lovely lady, Adam and Gidget, for bringing these ones up. I love them. First question. Which U.S. president was the only one to have the national debt paid in full? Yes, there was a time in the United States of America where we did not have a national debt. Oh, yeah, it was a while back. Well, this was an interesting answer we got because my good friend and fan, Andrea Baker, no relation that I'm aware of, but it's a great last name. She said John Adams or Andrew Jackson. For some reason, I remember this from history. Oh, Andrea, you should have guessed and just picked one. You had a 50-50 shot of winning, you know. Because, see, our good friend up in Michigan, Diane Pelkey, she nailed this one. She said that she thinks Andrea is right in saying Andrew Jackson. See, she stole your thunder. She sure did. Hey, like I said, you got to give it a shot. It said, which U.S. president was the only one? Not only ones. Which ones were the only ones? No. We said was the only one. That meant there could only be one. But yeah, so Diane Pelkey, you nailed it. You said Andrew Jackson. You said you weren't sure. Well, hey, you took a guess at it. And by golly, you nailed it. Wicked awesome job. Big love, Dr. Salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. That's what I'm saying. Well done, my friend. Well done. And then, the other trivia question. Another doozy. Although it was very easy to me because I know exactly how many days are in each month. 31 for January, 28, unless it's a leap year, that's 29 for February. March has 31, April has 30. May has 31, June has 30. July and August both have 31. September 30, October 31, November 30, December 31. Okay? So there you go. Yeah, I don't have to read nothing on that. I've got that memorized. I had it memorized since I was in kindergarten. I think even before then. My mother taught me well. All right, well, which month is the only one that can pass without a full moon? Gee, if you think about it long enough, you'll say, you know, the shortest month's February. That's got to be the only one. Well, hot diggity dog damn, Lisa Shrewsbury, she chimed in and said February. Well, hell yeah, Lisa. You nailed it. You got it right. Wicked awesome job. Big love, Dr. Salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, yeah. So, hey, cheers and beers, Lisa. Well done, my friend. Well done. All right. Do we have time for a couple quick additional shout-outs? Oh, yes, we do. And one of them I'm going to save for a moment. And the other one I want to say, hey, Glenn Ramsey, a weapons repairman that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Glenn, you're heading back to the East Coast. You're moving on to a new job. I'm mighty proud of you, and I am honored to have worked with you. I'm going to miss you, but you better keep in touch. If you don't keep in touch, I'm going to hunt you down because, see, I got connections in every state in the nation and most countries in the world because I know everybody. All right? Excuse me. Don't be a stranger. All right? Glenn, hell of a guy. Brother, enjoy. Have a safe trip. Much respect. And I'll give you a love, Dr. Salute. Been a while since I've given you a shout-out on Beer and Song of the Day, so you kind of, like Smith Barney, you made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. And I drink to you. All right. So with that said, we are saving the last shout-out for something special. Because, see, there's a celebrity birthday. A legendary New Jersey Devils goaltender. His name? Martin Brodeur. Oh, the guy's a badass. No doubt about it. Well, my good friend Mike Brodeur, the pride of Martha's Vineyard Regional High School class of 1990, and a wicked hardcore hockey fan. He's a Devils fan. Now, Mike, are you related to Martin Brodeur? I'm sure somewhere along the lines you are, you know? But Mike, always great chatting with you. I want to give you a shout-out and say, hey, what up, cuz? And I know you're pulling for your for the Montreal Canadiens over the Bruins. Why? Hey, part of his heritage. He's Canadian, eh? You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Ah, yeah, old Canada indeed. Canada, it's a wonderful country with a lot of good friends up there. But Mike, always great chat with you, my friend. You're an awesome guy. Wicked awesome. And cheers and beers to you. And go Bruins! Whoop that Canadian's ass, eh? Stupid Carey Price, flapping his man pleasers, having the nerve to say, oh, the Bruins got lucky. Hey, you know what, you schlepper? Let me tell you something. Maybe you were lucky. You had a lot of lucky saves and lucky bounces and stuff like that until we lit you up like a Christmas tree. Second half of the third period in game two. I hope your good luck has run out. Maybe that four-leaf clover that you had jammed up your ass rotted. That's what I'm thinking. We'll know tonight if you replaced it. You played a hell of a game against us in game one, and you were phenomenal for 2.5 periods in game two. So yeah, just go out there and kick some ass, you know, and stop flapping your man, please. Well, don't kick ass against my Bruins. But hey, you know, too bad. I kind of liked you prior to then. So talk trash, you get treated like trash, and we hope to whoop your ass. And I will drink to that. Go Bruins. Empty as brain cells when I have a Yankee fan. Oh, baby. Sam Adams, maple pecan porter. You know how much I love this stuff. This is grade A-plus quality beer right here. Pride of Boston, Massachusetts. 5.6% of exquisite wicked awesomeness. And let's bust this puppy open, shall we? Proper beer opening apparatus, proper technique. Oh, what a pop. It's like Carey Price pulling his head out of his ass after that stupid comment. Huh. 45 to grand right into the beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard. Because I'm just that damn good. I haven't spilled a drop yet. Never have, never will. Voila. Mm-hmm. So I say, hey, cheer the beers to all of you pros. They say in Germany, kapai, as they say in Japan. Oh, God. A plus all the way, man. I'm telling you, folks, Sam Adams made pecan porter. I cannot stress the awesomeness of this here beer, okay? Take it from the love doctor, your beer connoisseur. I know what I'm talking about. With that said, I think it's time we bust out our first hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day for you ladies and you men that love the men. And this guy I gained so much respect for in Super Bowl 38. Not a fan of his singing. Not really a fan of him. But thank you for the halftime show, Super Bowl 38, New England Patriots against the Carolina Panthers. I was hanging out in Japan with my good friend Dave Harvey. He's a wicked hardcore Panthers fan. I'm a wicked hardcore Patriots fan. And when Justin Timberlake took that puppy and whipped it out of Janet Jackson, that was truly the stuff of legends. Justin Timberlake, there you go. Hey, well, see, my good friend Sarah Milligan, we were talking a few days ago, and apparently there was quite a unique skit on with Justin Timberlake and Jimmy Fallon. Oh, I love Jimmy Fallon. Fever Pitch, great movie. If you're a Red Sox fan and you haven't watched Fever Pitch, you're not a Red Sox fan. Seriously, okay? It's about the only romantic comedy I'm going to watch. I'm not into those romantic comedy movies, but Jimmy Fallon, Drew Barrymore, Jimmy Fallon, of course, a wicked hardcore Red Sox fan. I mean, uber fan, folks. But yeah, listen to this. I want you to listen to this, and you can drool over Justin Timberlake for a moment. Hashtag with Jimmy Fallon and Justin Timberlake.
Busy working. Hashtag rise and grind. Hashtag is it Friday yet? Hey, check it out. I brought you some cookies. Hashtag homemade. Hashtag oatmeal raisin. Hashtag show me the cookie. Sweet. Hashtag don't mind if I don't. Pretty good. Hashtag getting my cookie on. Hashtag I'm the real cookie monster. Hashtag no, 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 no. Delicious, right? Hashtag I did it all for the cookie. Hashtag LOL, 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 LOL. Hashtag classic. By the way, did you catch last week's episode of Duck Dynasty? Hashtag quack, quack.
Nah, lately I've mostly been watching Netflix. Hashtag orange is the new black.
Oh, nice. I've been watching a lot of Barney the Dinosaur. Hashtag purple is the new black. Hashtag I love you, you love me, we're a happy family. Hashtag I'm 38. Hashtag dinosaurs. Hashtag how do they go extinct? Hashtag meteor. Hashtag ice age. Hashtag speaking of ice age, I just watched Ice Age on Demand the other day. Hashtag funny. Hashtag Ray Romano. Hashtag Deborah! Deborah! Hey, by the way, Halloween's only like a month away. I mean, do you know where you're going to be at? Hashtag life decisions. Hashtag sexy ghost.
I think I'm going to go as a ninja turtle. Hashtag gotta be Raphael. Hashtag Leonardo sucks. Hashtag the turtle, not the Italian Renaissance painter. Hashtag Mona Lisa. Hashtag, is she smiling? Hashtag speaking of smiling, I just saw my dentist. Hashtag bling. Hashtag dental care. Hashtag cavity free. Hashtag that's how we do. Hashtag we go hard. Hashtag and we can't stop.
We won't stop.
Hashtag we run this.
Hashtag true plans for life.
Hashtag is it worth it or let me work it.
Hashtag put my thing down, flip it and reverse it.
Hashtag is hashtag
is
hey
guys. Yeah, Quest?
What's up?
Hashtag shut the
f
up.
Yeah. You know, that's how I feel about hashtags. Twitter, you suck. And hashtags, overrated. Hashtags, hashtag GFY. That's right. Take that one. And shove it up your pie hole. God, I can't stand hashtags. Confusing, ridiculous. Ugh. I love that skit. And I want to thank you, Sarah Milligan, for sharing that one with me. I had never heard it before, and I'm giving you a love, Dr. Salute, for that one. I had to play that one. You recommended it, and I'm like, yeah, all right. Yeah, I'm glad I did. Great message. Hashtag suck ass, in my opinion. Okay. So, yeah, a lot of celebrity birthdays on this day. How about Willie Mays, the legendary Willie Mays, New York baseball Giants, San Francisco Giants. And New York Mets to finish out his career. We could have had him with the Boston Red Sox if our owner, Tom Yawkey, wasn't a racist prick. But Willie Mays, probably one of the greatest Major League Baseball players of all time and a class act all the way. 83 years old today, still going strong. Guy was incredible. George Clooney, actor, 53 years old. He's going strong. Another one is 53 years old today. How about this, eh? Wait a minute. I thought it was a... Just one that was one that was 53. Oh, yeah, Rona Downey, of course. Oh, she's a hottie. Touched by an angel. Yeah, I'd like to be touched by Rona Downey. If I'll sing, of course. Bing Crosby. Wait, nope. Looked up on my old notes. Disregard. How about Meek Mill? Meek Mill, rapper. He is 27 years old today. Chris Paul, phenomenal basketball player, Los Angeles Clippers. Chris Paul is 29 years old today. Tom Bergeron, actor, 59 and doing fine. Sigmund Freud. Oh, the legendary philosopher, badass Sigmund Freud, born on this day in 1856, passed away in 1939. Let me see what's next here. Ah, okay. Just had to see which baby of the day I had lined up first for all y'all out there. Okay? Oh, my God. I think it's time for some music. We'll finish off the celebrity birthdays, but you're going to love our first baby of the day. It's all about the Jays today. We had Jimmy Fallon. We're going to have Jessica Biel. That's her 18 years old, Gear Magazine. Yeah, baby. Jessica Biel, born March 3rd, 1982. She's hot, real hot, damn hot, wicked hot, smoking hot. Oh, yes. And all about the Jays today. Why not Jimmy Jones with the legendary song Good Time in 1959? I love this song. I think you will, too. About that for a falsetto. Oh, thong, 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 thong. That's like awesomeness right there. The only time you're going to hear a love doctor hit it that high is if he gets kicked in the nuts. Just saying. Ooh. Woo! Oh, cleavage! Thanks for cleavage. Ron panties. Hello. What would I- And I confirmed recently those are natural. I wasn't sure. They were almost too perfect. But guess what? I got a treat that I cannot show to you, the viewer. But I can eat, I can private message them to you or email them to you. She has done toplessness. I've seen her bare boobies. What a great song, huh? That's what real 50s pop music, a slight, not really R&B, more rock. It's just straight up rock and roll right there. Jimmy Jones. He also did the 1959 classic Handyman. I kind of had a dilemma between the two. Nice asset right there, huh? Damn right. Oh, former Prime Minister Tony Blair. Born this day in 1953. 61 today. Bob Seger. Of course, lead singer with the Silver Bullet Band. Against the Wind, great song right there. Bob Seger, 69 years old today. Great number. Jason Witten. Tight end number 82, Dallas Cowboys. Phenomenal, phenomenal football player. Class act all the way. He's considered one of the top 10 in when it comes to classiest players in the NFL. Jason Witten, much respect. He may play for the Cowgirls. But damn, what an awesome guy he is. And I think he's a first ballot Hall of Famer. 32 years old today. He's still got a few years to go. Hey, she's 32. And look at that. Ba-dunk-a-bonk-dunk-dunk-dunk. Nice ass. How about Daniel Alves? Hey, if you're a footy fan, or as they like to call it, football, or as they like to call it in America, soccer, it's football. It's footy, you know? Yeah, Daniel Alves out of Brazil. Phenomenal soccer player, football player. 31 years old today. Orson Welles. Oh, October 30th, 1938. War of the Worlds. That was one of the, that was the craziest thing ever heard on radio. People literally thought there was an alien invasion. Now, mind you, Orson Welles was only 23 when he wrote that. And Orson Welles, Citizen Kane, 1941. He was only 25, 26 years old. Orson Welles, born this day, 1915, passed away in 1985. A legend indeed. Oh, on the day that the Hindenburg disaster happened in Elmhurst, New Jersey. Yeah, the part of New York nobody wanted. Excuse me, yeah. May 6, 1937. Oh, the humanity! Yeah, very famous, the blimp that crashed, oh, airship, the Zeppelin, the Zeppelin crash, Parkhurst, New Jersey, not Elmhurst, Parkhurst, New Jersey, May 6, 1937, very famous, but on this day, May 6, 1937, a legendary badass was born, Reuben Hurricane Carter, that's right, phenomenal boxer, who ended up spending 19 years in prison for a crime he didn't commit. Charged and imprisoned for murder. He just passed away about a month ago of cancer. In 2004. Yeah, he passed away last month, folks. And I tell you, if you've never seen the movie The Hurricane with Denzel Washington, you have cheated yourself. You really have. Reuben Carter. Amazing story. No doubt. Robert Peary. Robert E. Peary, Admiral. Born in 1856, passed away in 1920. Yeah, he gets credited with first to the North Pole. But it was actually Matthew Henson that was the real one that got there first with Robert Peary. See, he was an African-American, and, you know, God forbid you give a black man credit over a white guy back in those days, you know. But either way, they both kicked ass, along with the four Eskimos that were with them. Oh, wow, that's kick ass right there, huh? So, yeah. February 6, 1909, 6 days before the NAACP was founded, the North Pole was discovered by Robert E. Peary and Matthew Henson, and four Eskimos who, sadly, we don't know their names. Shows how much treatment they get, huh? Jessica Jordan, hot model, Brazilian model, 30 years old today, stunningly gorgeous, future baby of the day, I'm thinking. Rudolph Valentino, there's a guy that should be hunk of the day. That guy was like the first true screen hottie, if you will. Well, hunk. Yeah, born in the state in 1825, passed away, or 1895, passed away in 1926, tragically at the age of 31. Rudolph Valentino, screen legend indeed. Oh, here's a legend, Russell Stover. The Russell Stover, that's right, Russell Stover chocolates, candies. Born in the state in 1888, passed away in 1955. Stuart Granger, actor. Oh, I can't show that one. Can't show those. Risky. From the movie Powder Blue, 2009, folks. Look up the pictures of that, and you will see her topless, okay? Take the Love Doctor's advice. You won't be disappointed. All right? Jessica Biel. Stuart Granger, actor, born in the state in 1913, passed away in 1993. I'll show that again. Herbie Cox, lead singer of the Cleftones, one of my favorite doo-wop groups of all time. From 1955 on, he's still performing today. He is 76 years old today. Awesome stuff. Dick Fosbury, famous for the Fosbury flop in the 1968 Mexico Olympics. Yeah, you know, jumping over the high jump, but he did it, you know, with his back. Prior to then, they always jumped over forward. Yeah, he's the first one to do it backwards. And that's how all the high jumpers do it nowadays. You can thank Dick Fosbury for that. He's 67 years old today. And former Baltimore Colts, New York Football Jets head coach, Weeb Eubank, born this day in 1907, passed away in 1998. Lots of pictures of her. I can never get tired of looking at the lovely, gorgeous, wicked awesome Jessica Biel. But I have to, and I'll drink to her. Farrah's got chili cooking right now. Farrah's world famous chili. It's the stuff of legends, and I'm looking forward to it. So let's feature our final hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Giggity. Jimmy Fallon. Oh, yeah. Another J. You damn right. Josh Biggin' a Love Maker. He's featuring the J's. There they are, those goofballs. I don't know. That hashtag skit was hilarious. They've also got some rap ones out there. I was looking at some of this stuff. Might have to feature some of their rap ones. History of Rap. These two guys really made it happen. Jimmy Fallon, Justin Timberlake. It was hilarious. Oh, dear Lord. There you go. There's a male ass for you, ladies. And you men that love the men. Bare assets? Sure. Ugh. I'm scarred for life and my hand's contaminated now. Thanks. Hey, gotta keep our female fans and our homosexual fans happy, you know? Because, hey, it's all about the love. Whether you love the males, the females, whether you're same or hetero, it does not matter. All that matters is that you're happy. On this day, 2013, Walmart revenue exceeds that of ExxonMobil, becoming the largest company by revenue on the Fortune 500 list. Well, there you go, Walmart. And enjoy your customers, too. The ones that, oh, jeez. I'll leave that alone. All right. Hey, Glenn Ramsey. Dude, this blew me away. Remember we were talking hockey earlier today? When you were saying bye to me, we were talking about your Carolina Hurricanes. You're a fan of the Carolina Hurricanes. Well, check this out. No bullshit. On this day in 1997, the NHL's Hartford Whalers become the Carolina Hurricanes. Crazy, isn't it? I didn't know that. I did not know that until I saw it. I was like, dude, it was meant to give you a shout out on today's show, you know? Amazing how that happens. On this day in 1995, Classic Sports Network begins on cable television. Makes me happy. I love them old school sports. I love seeing some of the great stuff. You know, sometimes I don't like seeing, like, you know, the Red Sox losing, the Buckner ball, things of that nature. Ugh. On this day in 1995, the channel connecting England and France officially opens. Awesome stuff. Also on this day in 1995, comedian Bobcat Goldthwait. Oh, he's a trip. He sets fire to the couch on the Tonight Show. Yeah, the guy's a real fruitcake, but that's funny. 20 years ago, jeez, I remember hearing about it like it was yesterday. Arze in 1991, Seppo Ratti of Finland, listen to this one, sets a javelin record throw of 301 feet 9 inches. Good God, that's wicked far. Honest Day in 1987, Mario Andretti, no surprise here, sets a one-lap speed record at Indy, 218.204 miles per hour. Honest Day in 1987 as well. Miroslav Mihailovic begins 54 hours straight of telling jokes. God, I hope he had a... I hope he was hilarious, because otherwise that was 54 hours of crap. Wow. Honest Day in 1975, 40 years ago today, smallest attendance at Philadelphia's Veterans Stadium. Yeah, that dump. 4,149 people. That's it. That's pathetic. All right, well, let's get to the final song of the day. We'll get to the final baby of the day in just a sec. How about some real blues right here? Because I didn't even get to play any blues yesterday. Jimmy Johnson. Got to go with the J's, baby. That's what I'm saying. Poor Boy's Dream, I believe 1975 on this one. 1974, Poor Boy's Dream, great song, Jimmy Johnson. As we show off, I know my lovely lady Admin Gidget loves this girl, because she's a Mad Men fan, January Jones. And yes, she was born in January. January 5th in the year of our Lord, 1978. Nice Brian Panty set. Let's show it again, eh? That's a poor boy's dream. That's a rich boy's dream. Clavage. It's ridiculous how hot this woman is. Even look a little trashy, she looks hot. Oh, look at her hair, though. Stunning. X-Men, that's right. That's how you, this is my personal favorite picture of her. Younger, nice, beautiful, matching bra and panty set. That'll make you blow your horn like that, you know? Just saying. Honest Day 1973, first World Hockey Association Championship. Excuse me. The New England Whalers, imagine that, beat the Winnipeg Jets 4-1. Honest Day 1970. Yuichiro Miura of Japan skis down Mount Everest. I think the guy was a kamikaze kind of guy, you know? That's crazy. Bad enough climbing that son of a bitch. And skiing down it? That's just insane, the membrane. Honest Day 1957. Last broadcast of I Love Lucy on CBS television. Naked! But no nerp, otherwise I wouldn't be able to show that picture. Like I said, oh, I couldn't even think of the name of it earlier. But on this day in 1937, the day that Reuben Carter was born, the dirigible Hindenburg explodes in flames at Lakehurst, New Jersey. 36 people were killed. Oh, the humanity. Honest Day in 1955. See, that's why I use show notes, folks. I don't memorize everything. Honest Day in 1954. 60 years ago today, a big day indeed. Roger Bannister of Jolly Old England, as we represent my heritage, and Roger Bannister, breaks the 4-minute mile, first person ever in recorded history to run a mile in less than 4 minutes. That is wicked fast. 3 minutes and 59.4 seconds. Honest Day in 1935, the Pulitzer Prize awarded to Audrey Werdemann for Bright Ambush. Why the hell did I keep that there? That's how I feel about that. Who gives a shit? Maybe you voracious readers out there do. I don't. Honestly, 1934, though, 80 years ago today, my Boston Red Sox scored 12 runs in the fourth inning. Listen to this one. Including a record 4 consecutive triples. They were hit by Kyle Reynolds, Moose Salters, Rick Farrell, and they didn't know his first name, B. Walters. I didn't get a chance to research the name, but yeah, it's a miracle if you see back-to-back triples, let alone 4 consecutive back-to-back-to-back-to-back triples. Un-freaking-real. Aussie 1925, Ty Cobb hits his 5th home run in 2 games. That tied Cap Anson's record from 1885. Difference is Cap Anson did it in the dead ball era. But Cap Anson was also the most racist prick in Major League Baseball history. You can thank him for blacks being barred from baseball. Him and a number of others. And of course, Ty Cobb, one of the biggest assholes in baseball history. So yeah, great baseball players, total douchebags. Gee, kind of like A-Roid. I don't even think A-Roid's that bad, personally. On this day in 1921, the American Soccer League forms. Yay, soccer! On this day in 1915, Red Sox Babe Ruth pitching debut and first home run. His first major league home run and his first time pitching for my beloved Boston Red Sox. But them stupid New York Yankees they beat us 4-3 in 15 innings. Yep, that just shows the curse of the Babes died in 99 years ago. That was even before we sold them. Oh, wait, no, we did win the World Series in 1915, 16, and 18. All right, scratch that from the record. All right, say in 1890, the Mormon Church renounces polygamy. Well, shit, why deny yourself of multiple wives if they're willing? I don't know. I couldn't do that. One woman is more than I can handle. I'm married to royalty. Doesn't get any better than that. On in 1889, the Universal Exposition opens in Paris, France. The Eiffel Tower is completed. Hey, all right. On in 1861, Jefferson Davis approves a bill declaring war between the United States and the Confederacy. Yeah. Hey, you think you're going to, they say the South's going to do it again? You lost the first time, so what, you going to lose again? Sure, go for it. Bring it. On this day in 1851, Dr. John Gorey patents a refrigeration device, or machine rather. Thank you for that. Without you, I wouldn't have cold beer. Worthy of a love doctor salute. On this day also in 1851, Linus Yale patents that famous Yale lock. How about that? On this day in 1835, first edition of New York Herald is printed. Price, 1 cent. Yay! On this day in 1833, John Deere, there you go, he makes the first ever steel plow. On this day in 1787, for those that are Masonic brethren, I can respect this, because I am a fellow Mason. Marine Lodge, Falmouth, Massachusetts. We don't have numbered lodges in Massachusetts. If you want to know more, just ask. But, on this day in 1787, first Black Masonic Lodge, African number 459 forms, Prince Hall, Boston, Massachusetts. How ironic. Black Lodge had a number, but see, we don't have Black Lodges anymore. No. Because racism's stupid, segregation's dumber than a second coat of paint, to quote the late, great George Carlin. And we are all equals, we are all equally worthwhile, we are all equally worthless. So yeah, you're a Mason, regardless of race, we love you like a fellow brother. And not in a West Virginia way. I had to go there. On day 1733, first international boxing match, Bob Whitaker beats Tito Ticani. And finally on this day in 1642, Ville-Marie forms. What's Ville-Marie? We know it today as Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Happy birthday, Montreal! I hope my Boston Bruins whoop the ever-living shit out of you, okay? Or as you like to say in French, merde, merde, oh shit, merde, oh merde. Yeah. Oh, you stay mad all night with my Boston Bruins. Stomp your dick in the dirt. With that, I drink the rest. Empty as the brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, time to make like a fetus a head out so everybody take care of a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. Might spill your drink. I might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is also dumber than being a New York Yankees fan. What's dumber than that is rooting for puke-infested goober schnitzels like Eli.
Oh, I'm good, Tom Brady.
Yeah, but you and your brother and your dad have the same amount of rings, dickhead. Manning! Or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people to watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports, defends, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a big fat. Yep, GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. See y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Time to go have some chili and time to go watch them Boston Bruins hopefully beat the shit out of them Montreal Canadiens, eh? Damn right. Go Bruins.